Hey guys, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to use Bing, which is a new search engine that's powered by ChatGPT, which is a large language model that we previously used. And this time, I'm going to use it to write a case report. And the best thing about using Bing is that it actually has real publications and real articles, which is a big issue that we encountered when we were using ChatGPT previously. And not only that, since Bing is actually using real live internet searches, it's actually up to date more so than since 2021. Which is the data that was used to actually train ChatGPT previously. We've had a lot of discussion, a lot of comments about the use of ChatGPT and artificial intelligence and its role in scientific writing. I think that's a really great point, and I don't know that there's a correct answer right now, as there's a lot of things that are ongoing in the development space in terms of with policies and regulations surrounding this issue. So I think that one of the things I found very interesting is that there are journals out there that are recommending and encouraging the use of ChatGPT to be used in scientific writing. And this is just, for example, I found that there's a Curious, which is a part of Springer Nature. They're calling for case reports contests that is written with assistance of ChatGPT. So if you like this sort of content, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button below. And so let's go ahead and get started. So this is the finished product when we're using Bing AI to write a case report. In this case report, we cover the prurigo pigmentosa associated with the ketogenic diet mimicking herpes zoster. So to show you how to write the abstract, the introduction, the case report using chart data, basically taken from the medical chart, and then rephrased into a scientific writing style, and then plugged into the case report itself. And we're able to write the full discussion section. I wanted to note that while Bing AI was able to generate this content, it actually used a lot of references that a further prompt to be able to actually list. Initially, it only provided citations from 1 to 4, for example, but upon further prompting, was able to provide all of it. And as a result of that, though, it did not provide all of the in-text citations. And so while these citations were probably used to actually write the actual discussion section, not all of them are correctly cited within the text itself. But I wanted to provide it here for completeness. So in order to access the new Bing feature, we actually have to get onto the wait list. And so in order to do so, we have to go to here, we search Bing AI, this. And then so here, after going to bing.com/new and hitting this join the waitlist button, typically after joining the waitlist, it took me about 1 week to be able to get off of it. But then after that, you're actually able to use Bing. And so this is what it looks like here. And so we have the new introducing the new Bing. There's a lot of different features that it can actually do, like create a 3-course menu, write a rhyming poem, and write a story, for example, and creating trivia posts. But for our purposes here, we wanted to use it to actually write a case report. Just go to bing.com. And then this is what it currently looks like. If you want to do the chat feature, you can click on the chat feature here, and it's going to automatically bring up this chat box. And so to be able to use this chat box, we can then type to do anything. For our purposes, we're going to be writing a case report. So I'm going to go ahead and write, please help me write a case report.
Please read and label this text, text one.
So this is the information that I actually want to use in my case report. So this is sample data that's not actually for a real patient, but was a case report that I actually wanted to make previously as a medical student. So this is directly from the chart, or what we would have had from the chart. And so we're going to copy and paste this directly into the Bing search so that this is remembered as our text number one. And it says, I've understood and have read and labeled the text. And do you want me to do anything else with it? I'm going to say, please help me write an introduction to case report or medical journal publication using text. And so let's see what this is able to actually generate. And so here we already see that it was able to actually generate this. And it's also been able to provide a few of the journal articles and publications and citations that it was previously using. So to be a little bit more specific, though, I want to say,
please help me write an introduction for a case report using scientific articles published in journals from PubMed.
Text. And we see here that it's able to actually punch out a lot of good information. It's able to say prurigo nodosum is a rare inflammatory dermatitis first described by Nagishima in 1971. Not only that, it's able to actually provide us with the PubMed journals. And so if we click on this here, we see that this does link to prurigo pigmentosa, a literature review. This is from an article published in 2015, which is great. And so let's say that now we want to actually go ahead and write the discussion section as well. And the other thing that I found really helpful was that we can actually make a table of the references rather than just showing it here.
Please present the references in a table format with column 1 indicating name of article, second column, the year of the publication, third column, first name of the author. Note that this is not always correct. Fourth column, 25-word summary of the article, and then the fifth column, the URL to the article. There can also be a sixth column that indicates the title of the article, and these can be rearranged in whatever order of columns that you prefer.
And so if we're able to punch this out, this should give us the discussion section of the actual case report itself, and then also providing the references in a table format so that we can then actually quickly look to see what those articles are being pulled in. So it's really punching out some great data and information here. It's providing the mechanism of action, which is currently unknown, but does suggest some other things such as it could be, such as oxidative stress and altered immune responses, and then goes through the diagnosis of how to actually do this, which includes a skin biopsy, and then it can also discuss about the treatment. And then here it's actually going through, as I mentioned before, it's going to put the name of the article, the year that is published, the name of the actual author, and then the discussion or the quick summary about the article and then the actual PubMed reference. And so we can see here that it didn't actually do all of them. And so this is one thing that I realized that has been happening with Bing is that it doesn't always put in all those articles that we want to actually have those references, which is a little more challenging. But the best thing about this is that these are actual real articles rather than the issue that we came into contact with before with ChatGPT, which was basically a bunch of fake articles that was generated, and we had to use a different web plugin. So now that we've used it to actually generate the discussion section, we can then go on to write the actual meat within the case report itself. So this is basically when we want to rephrase what we captured from the medical chart, which is text number one up here, and we want to rephrase it into a case report format. And so this is one of the interesting things I found about Bing is that whenever I'm able to use this and do this, it actually sometimes just punches out the entire case report for me. So let's see.
Please write text one in a case report format.
And so here, this is actually writing the entire case report for us, so that we didn't even need to go through all of that. So sometimes this is the thing that I found with Bing, in that it actually writes this just using this, but other times whenever I tried to use Bing to write a case report, it correctly stated that it was unable to do so just because it was an algorithm that is not correctly trained how to write case reports and actually encouraged you to do a lot more scientific review, but can also help you write the introduction and discussion sections. So here it's going through, it's actually providing a figure one, a figure two, and this is the issue with Bing also, that it takes the data that I'm putting in, but it's also making up a bunch of stuff. So like in our case, our patient was actually not treated with anything. But in this case, the patient was treated with clobetasol cream. And so there's some issues with Bing that it actually puts in incorrect information or just kind of uses the data online and then puts it into your case report, which is not always the greatest thing.
Please rephrase the following text below into a medical professional format for scientific publication.
So this was able to do it better. And this takes our text actually, it's not taken any text from outside. So it's able to generate something that's more accurate to the text that we provided and not just putting in some data that was found from the internet. And then so we describe the case of a 30-year-old woman who presented with a 3-month history of paradic papulovesicular rash in the back and the arms, had no relevant past medical history. So it's able to read the abbreviation of PMHX and able to put in some data for us. And then now it was able to include the differential diagnosis, which we put in, and then the skin biopsy was inconclusive. And then based off the clinical evolution and the history of ketosis, a diagnosis of PP was made, or prurigo pigmentosa. So this is actually really, really well done. And so putting all of that together, then I'm able to write the case report. So let's go over some of the pros and cons of using Bing to actually case report in for scientific writing. And so one of the best pros about using Bing compared to ChatGPT is that it uses real publications and citations. ChatGPT had a really big issue of making up citations or citing something in the article didn't even exist. Also, Bing is up to date in that it uses articles after 2021 because it uses real live searches on the internet currently versus ChatGPT, which is trained on data prior to 2021. Bing also has a larger word limit. It's much faster than ChatGPT since it's a chatbot. ChatGPT actually had to have a long wait. And even nowadays, there's a lot of users currently using it, so there's a lot of throttling and sometimes just data lag in between. Using Bing is a really big time saver and rapidly accelerates your writing, as illustrated here. It also has a really professional writing style. I can take data directly from the medical chart, putting into Bing, and then ask it to rephrase the text, and it was able to do so in a medical kind of scientific format. Also, it's a very simple chatbot interface that, you know, many people can use, from students to medical professionals, for example. Let's cover some of the cons of using Bing. There's a big risk of plagiarism, as we demonstrated here. When we put in the text that was generated from the discussion section into a chatbot AI detector, it was able to say that this was human-generated content. But when we put it into the Grammarly plagiarism checker, there's significant issues with plagiarism. So using this tool should just be a tool and not your main content generation for these scientific articles. And so when you're using Bing, this is just something to be aware of because there is this high risk of plagiarism if you use this ethically in your case reports, in your scientific writing. Also, another big issue with Bing is that it's unable to link up to greater than 6 publications at a time. And so when we're generating those large bodies of text in the discussion section, there's not actually that many articles that are being linked. Sometimes it's up to just 4. And sometimes whenever you're using those, Bing will be able to generate a large body of text, but it's only using like sometimes 1 or 3 references. And so you're going to need a lot more references whenever you're actually writing a case report or any sort of scientific article. Another big issue with Bing in its current state is it's currently limited to just 8 conversation exchanges at a time. After that, then you're going to have to get kicked off and you have to start a new chat. And so it doesn't remember the prior context and the prior text before that. So you're going to have to restart all over again, which sometimes can be difficult. So in order to get around that, you have to combine such as asking Bing to write a discussion section and also generate the table at the same time for the references. And then lastly, in our particular instance, since we're writing a case report, sometimes when we ask Bing to write the section for the case report itself, rephrasing our particular text that comes from the medical record, it basically just fills in information for where it found online. For example, in our case, the patient was not treated, but in our text that it generated, it says that our patient was treated with a particular treatment that was generated from a different case report. So that's probably where a lot of the plagiarism issues are also coming into context. So overall, I think that Bing in its current state is really helpful to help you generate outlines, to help you summarize text, to help you get started. But there's still a lot more underway to develop a system where it's actually generating good references, actually referencing correctly, and not generating any particularly high risk for plagiarism. And so there are currently down the pipeline a few other algorithms and language models, such as BioGPT, which is currently being used by Microsoft to help Q&A and also reference the PubMed data so that it's actually a lot more legitimate. And so it's trained on PubMed data specifically.